Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to Madam Day Mathematics class. We will continue our Mathematics Year 5 with the topic of addition of time. These are the units of time that we need to learn in addition. For today, I will focus on these three. The first one, years and months, hours and minutes, and then days and hours. Let's look at example one. 2 and 1 over 2 years plus 3 and 1 over 4 years equal to the answer in years also. So for this question, all the units are same. Semua unitnya sama. Jawapan nak dalam tahun, years juga. So, kita tak perlu tukar unit. We just add up like this. Kita tambah macam tajuk pecahan yang biasa. So, if you want to add, first step you must make sure the both denominators are same. Kena pastikan penyebut ini sama. Kalau tak sama, tak boleh tambah. Okay, so 2 boleh tak jadi 4? Can, right? So 2 we can times 2, then we get 4. And then the BFF on top, we also times 2. Ingat ya, apa yang bawah buat, atas mesti ikut BFF. Okay? So I will get 1 times 2, 2, 2 times 2, 4. And then plus 3 and 1 over 4. And finally, when I add up the whole number plus whole number, so I get 5. 2 plus 3, I get 5. And then the numerator plus numerator, atas tambah atas. 2 plus 1 is 3 over 4. So done. This is the answer for example 1. 5, 3 over 4 years. Example 2, 1.25 years plus 1.5 years, and the answer is also in years. Jadi, semuanya masih sama. So, for this question, you also no need to convert the unit. Tak payah tukar unit. So, this one, decimal, decimal. So, we add like this. Okay? When you arrange, be careful. The decimal point must be at the same column. Mesti sebaris ya, titik perpuluhan. And then look at this one, 1.5, and then I add a zero behind. Okay, so 5 plus 5, 5, 2 plus 5, 7, 1 plus 1 is 2. So at last I will get 2.75. So I just write the answer on top, 2.75 years. Example 3, 2 and 1 over 2 years plus 5 years, 9 months, and then the answer in years and months. Alright, when you see the question like this, now the first step we compare the unit first. Bandingkan unit dulu. Tengok jawapan, dia nak years and months. So, 5 years, 9 months, you no need to change. Sebab sudah dalam bentuk jawapan yang kita nak, tak payah tukar. Okay? So, yang kita perlu tukar, 2 and 1 over 2 years. The first one, ni kena tukar. So, you must remember, 1 year is equal to 12 months. Sebab ini years dengan months, 1 tahun 12 bulan. 1 year, 12 months. So, if you want to convert from years to months, you need to times 12. So, I circle this because I need to convert now. Alright. So, for the mixed number, 2, 1 over 2, I separate it like this. Saya ceraikan macam ni. 2 years plus 1 over 2 years. Okay, kenapa saya nak pisahkan macam ni? Sebab jawapan ini dalam years dan months. Okay? So kita sudah ada years kat sini depan ni. 2 years. So these 2 years you no need to convert. Yang 2 tahun ini tak perlu tukar. Alright? Sebab kita nak jawapan bentuk ini. So these 2 I just write down. Bawa turun saja 2 years. Okay? Yang kita perlu tukar 1 over 2 years. This one we need to convert to months. 1 over 2 years convert to months. So, if convert to months, we need to times 12. So, 1 over 2 times 12. Alright, I can simplify 2 and 12. We can divide by 2. Dalam sifir 2, okay, boleh bahagi. 2 divide 2, we get 1. 12 divide 2, we get 6. And then 1 times 6, I will get 6 months. And then, how many months here? Is 6 months. Alright. So now, I already convert this. 2 years, 2, 1 over 2 years, I already convert to 2 years, 6 months. Okay, saya baru je tukar yang pertama. Ni ya, step 1. After that, we need to do this. Plus 5 years, 9 months. Okay, sudah tukar, baru kita tambah. Sebab pattern dia dah sama kan? Years, month. Ini pun years, month. So, sekarang kita nak tambah. Okay, bila ada years and months, we need to use the table like this. Okay? So, I fill in 2 years, 6 months. So, first row, I write 2 years, 6 months. Plus with 5 years, 9 months. So, I write here 5, 9. After that, we start from months. Mula dengan months. 6 plus 9, we get 15. Tulis terus 15 dekat sini. Okay? And then 2 years plus 5 years, we get 7. Alright. Now, you look at the months. Tengok bahagian months. 1 years, we have 12 months only. 15 already more than 12. 1 tahun ada 12 bulan. 15 sudah lebih daripada 12. Alright? So, I need to minus 12. Saya kena bawa 12 ni kepada tahun. Okay? And then plus 1 years. Okay, 12 tahun, 12 bulan ini saya tukar kepada tahun. So, I need to minus 12 months and then plus 1 years. So, 15 minus 2, I will get 3. 7 plus 1, I will get 8. So, done. This is the answer. 8 years and 3 months. Example 4, 1 over 3 hours plus 50 minutes, the answer in minutes. Okay, for this one, minutes, and this is hour. Of course, we need to change the hour to minutes. Mestilah tukar hour kepada minutes. Okay, so now, what is the relationship for hours and minutes? 1 hour equal to 60 minutes. So if you want to convert hours to minutes, we need to times 60. Okay, so I circle this one. Now I want to convert to minutes. So 1 over 3 times 60. Sebab nak tukar unit ya sekarang. Alright, so I can cancel. Divide 3. 3 divide 3, I get 1. 60 divide 3 is 20. So I get 20 minutes. 1 over 3 hours is 20 minutes. And then, not finished yet, we need to plus 50 minutes. Okay, this first step, I only convert 1 over 3 hours to minutes. Now, second step, I need to add up 50 minutes plus 20 minutes. So the answer is 70 minutes. Example 5, 1 over 4 hours plus 0.75 hours equals to minutes. Answer in minutes. Jawapan nak minutes. So means that both of these number we need to convert to minutes. Kedua-dua ini pun kita kena tukar dulu kepada minutes, baru kita tambah. Okay? So, hours and minutes, this one, convert to minutes, we need to times 60. So, first, I start with 1 hour, 4 hours. So, I need to times 60. And then, 4 and 60 can divide 4. So I cancel, become 1, and then 60 divided 4, I will get 15. So this is 15 minutes. After that, 0.75. Okay, now convert to minutes times 60 also. So 0.75 times 60. Okay, now you see, this is a zero, so I write a zero here, and then I start to multiply 6 with 5. 6 times 5 is 30, so 3 I will write on top, 3. After that, 6 times 7, 42, plus 3 is 45, so I write 5 here, and then 4 on top. 600 plus 4 is 4. And don't forget your point. 1 decimal place, 2 decimal place, point. So answer also 1, 2 decimal place, and then point here. Okay, so this is 45 minutes. Now, not finished yet. We need to add, because we not yet settle this, add. Okay, so what plus what? 1 over 4 hour, we already convert to 50 minutes. And then 0.75 hours, we already convert to 45 minutes. Okay, kita dah tukar. So now we just add up 15 plus 45. And then the answer is 60 minutes. Let's look at example 6. 1 over 6 days plus 1 day 5 hours. And then the answer is in days and hours. Okay, this is days and hours. So, remember, 1 day is equal to 24 hours. If you want to convert, you need to times 24. 1 day 5 hours. Already in days and hours, so we no need to change this. What we need to do now is convert 1 over 6 days to days and hours, like this. Okay, ini kita kena tukar je. Kita buat 1 day plus 1 over 6 day. Okay, and then you need to write the answer like this. You convert to this form. Tukar kepada bentuk macam ini. Sebab jawapan nak days and hours. So, 1 day sudah ada. Turunkan 1 sahaja. And then, 1 over 6 day, we need to times 24. 6 and 24 can divide 6. 6 divide 6, we get 1. 24 divided by 6, we get 4. So, at last, 1 times 4, we will get 4 hours. So, now, I fill in the 4 hours here. Okay, sekarang dah siap tukar. Pecahan ini, saya dah siap tukar 1 day, 4 hours. Now, we need to plus 1 day, 5 hours. 1 day, 4 hours plus 1 day, 5 hours. Okay, bila days and hours, kita kena guna table, guna jadual macam ni. masukkan 1 day 4 hours, 1 day 5 hours and then plus 4 plus 5, 9, 1 plus 1, 2. And then you need to make sure here, hours. Dekat tempat hours ni, jawapan ni, awak kena pastikan tak boleh lebih 24. Tak boleh lebih 24. Cannot more than 24. Because one day is equal to 24 hours. Okay? If more than 24, we need to minus 24 hours and then plus one day. For this question, we no need to minus. Because 9 hours only. Tak lebih daripada 24. So, tak payah tolak. So, we can write the answer on top. 2 days and 9 hours. Now, example 7. Days and then days and hours. Answer in days and hours. So, for sure, 9 days, 18 hours, we no need to change. Tak payah convert yang ini. And then, we need to convert 4.75 days. Yang ini kita kena tukar. Okay? So, kita kena times 24 later. This one, 4.75, kita nak tukar jawapan macam ni. Days and hours. So, I need to separate it, pisahkan dia. Whole number, I will write the whole number, nombor bulat, 4 days. And then, the decimal is 0.75 days. Okay, saya kena pisahkan macam ini dulu. And then, day, I can write down the 4 here, 4 days. After that, this decimal, 0.75, then I need to times with 24. I need to convert to hours. Okay, 0.75 days ni saya nak tukar kepada hours. So, kena darab 24. Alright? So, now I start with this one. 4 times 5, 20. So, I write 2, 0. After that, 4, 7, 28 plus 2 is 30. So, I write 3, 0. And then 4 times 0 is 0. And plus 3, I will get 3. Next one. For this 2, 2 times 5, 10. So, 1, 0, 10 here. After that, 2 times 7, 14. 14 plus 1, 15. So, 1, 5. 2 times 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. So, at last, I add up 0, 0, 3 plus 5, 8, and then I get 1. Don't forget point, 1, 2 decimal place, point. 1, 2, point. Okay, so this is 18. So, I will write 18 here. 18 hours. Now, we just finish convert days to this one, 4.7 days. We just finish convert. Now, we need to add plus this one. Okay, so I need to use a table again. 4 day 18 hours right inside and then plus 9 day 18 hours like this. After that, we plus 18 plus 18 start from hours, right? Start from hours. 18 plus 18 is 36. 4 plus 9 is 13. Okay, look at the hour, 36. Is it more than 24? Yes, right. So, we need to continue minus 24 plus 1. Okay, sebab dia tak boleh lebih 24. sudah lebih kena tolak and then tambah 1 hari. So this one, 36 minus 24, I will get 12. 13 plus 1 is 14. So we write the answer on top. 14 days, 12 hours. Example 8. Days, answer also in days and hours. Okay? Answer like this, days and hours. This one, days only. So both also I need to change. Dua-dua pun kena tukar. Tukar kepada bentuk days and hours. Okay? So I start with 3, 1 over 2. So macam tadi, pisahkan, separate it. 3 days plus 1 over 2 days. And then you write this form. Turunkan 3, 3. Then we need to convert 1 over 2 days times 24. Okay. And then simplify, divide 2, divide 2. 24 divide 2, I get 12. And then 1 times 12, I get 12 hours. Okay, dapat 12 hours. Next one, 8.25 days. Okay, ini pun kena pisahkan, separate it. Pisahkan whole number dengan decimal. So, this one will become like this. 8 days, 0.25 days. Tukar macam ni. So, 8 days kita boleh isi dulu. Sekarang nak tukar. 0.25 days convert to hours. So 0.25 times 24. Okay. So 4 times 5, 20. I need to write 2 on top, 20. 4 times 2, 8. 8 plus 2 is 10, 10. 400 plus 1, 1. After that, start with this one. 2, 5, I get 10. 10. So, I need to write 1 on top. I use blue color. 1 on top. 0. 2, 2, 4. Plus 1 is 5. And then 2, 0, 0. And the last step, we just add up. And don't forget the point. This one. 1, 2 decimal place, 1, 2 decimal place, point here. Okay, so it's 6 hours. So I write this one, I will bring here. Okay, 6 hours. And not finished yet. One more step, we need to add up. Tambah, belum siap lagi tambah. We just convert. So we use a table. This one, we take this one. 3 days, 12 hours, plus 8 days, 6 hours. And then 12 plus 6 is 18. 3 plus 8 is 11. And then check your hours. Is it more than 24? No. So this is the final answer. No need to minus 24 because it is not more than 24. So 11 days, 18 hours. That's all for today. Thank you and happy learning at home.